I don't think anybody will disagree with me here. The Linux kernel is one of the most important pieces of software in the entire world, either being directly involved or connected to basically everything in the tech world. It's pretty much impossible to escape, making it an obvious target for malicious commits. And of course, we have this very famous clip.
Have any of you been approached by the US for a backdoor?
No.
Obviously a joke. How much of a joke is it? I don't know. Why is it so bright now? I'm gonna close my window some more. Linus and everybody else involved understands the importance of this project, and the second that anything slightly shady happens, anything that seems a little bit off, like somebody's trying to do something malicious, nuke it from orbit. Deal with it now, and then work out why it happened later. And that is exactly what happened with a recent patch set made for the 6.16 RC1 patch cycle made by Kees Cook. Now, for anyone who doesn't know, Kees has been in the Linux world, in the Unix world, for a very, very long time. Back in the 90s, as a Unix admin at Motorola, AT&T, and Walgreens, has been an embedded systems engineer for a very long time, an Ubuntu security engineer, and currently a kernel security engineer at Google for the past 14 years. This isn't some, like, new developer, some one-off contributor, anything like that. This is someone with a very proven track record who shows they are a good kernel developer, who shows that they know exactly what they're doing, and they've never done anything weird. And if they do anything weird, they're specifically gonna ask, is this okay? Can I do this weird thing? Before they go and do something. So at very first glance, if you see someone with a track record like this, do something kind of shady, do something which looks malicious, looks like they're trying to inject code, which is not supposed to be injected, either they're playing the crazy long game, have been going at it for 28 years, and then decide to go rogue, or far more likely than that, they have a compromised account. So you gotta do something about this very quickly. So Linus Torvalds had a normal Linus moment. WTF Kees, you seem to have actively maliciously modified your tree completely. There are completely crazy commits in there that are entirely fake. You have this merge tag driver core 6.16 RC1 of this right here, which claims to be from me and committed by me, which is very much not. It's some garbage you have entirely made up. It is a real commit from Linus, but the SHA-ID is entirely different, and this isn't some kind of innocent rebasing mistake, because this actively lies about who committed it. This is completely unacceptable. I will now refuse to pull anything from you until you explain what the F you've been up to, because this looks like you've been doing actively bad things. You need to nuke that tree and come up with a good explanation for this kind of shit. I'm CCing Constantine because I really think these kinds of games are completely unacceptable, and this is not the kind of behavior we can have on kernel.org accounts. Constantine, please disable Keys' account immediately until this is cleared up, because this looks malicious. Now, you might say this is a crazy overreaction. He didn't need to insult Keys or anything like that. He could have just said, oh, well, let's just work out what happened here. And sure, yeah, I get it. This is Linus. This is the way that Linus talks, and it's very much straight to the point. You need to understand the position that Linus is in here, because Linus has to deal with people who are being actively malicious, who aren't maybe on a compromised account or maybe broke some scripting, anything like that. Somebody who is actually trying to do something bad. And when you see something as bad as this tree, where you have faked commits, faked SHA-IDs, all of this stuff, you have to assume that this is as bad as it's gonna get. And you need to deal with this immediately before more code is submitted, and then maybe someone like Greg comes along, submits the patch set, not knowing every single commit that Linus has done, and then you have dangerous code in the tree. Even if it's gonna be dealt with quickly, you don't ever want that near the tree. So Constantine didn't ask any questions, and the first thing he said, okay, account disabled, Let's just wait. Now, Keys could have gotten angry with Linus, gotten defensive, started yelling at him, all this sort of stuff, and I would get why someone would do that. But he understood the position that he was in right now. He understood how bad this looked, and he needed to deal with this as smoothly as possible. So this is the response that he had. I have no idea. I had noticed a bunch of trees refusing to have scene merges. I kept trying to rebase them to sort it out, but it seems it has not worked. This is all on top of an SSD that was getting mad at me, and I had to replace it, but it threw errors during the copy. I thought everything got recovered in my various work trees, but clearly something is still wrong. I'll throw it out and rebuild from patches. Sorry? As far as I can tell, it's all just from broken trees I tried to reconstruct. Badly, it seemed. Since I can't push to kernel.org, what should I do for resetting this PR after I've reconstructed everything? And Linus responded back. The rebase history would explain that, but the reason I'm upset about it is because I don't even see how that rebasing could possibly happen by mistake. Any normal git merge rebasing should rewrite the committer, so to get the kinds of rewritten history that I saw, it almost has to be intentional. I don't see how that has happened by mistake. At a minimum, there is some truly effed up scripting going on. He hit the nail on the head, and we'll get to that very soon, because it wasn't just one or two commits, it was a whole slew of them. I mentioned one, but there were thousands of rewritten commits. That bad branch of yours had 330 merge commits that were attributed to me, both authorship and commit information, and weren't actually from my tree. And those are just my commits. Never mind the 6,000 plus other commits that didn't purport to be back from me. This is not some disk corruption issue. There was some real work involved in recreating 330 copies of my merges and 6,000 copies of other people's commits. I only looked at one, but it appears identical except for the lack of source tag signature information, and then all the subsequent ones that append on it will obviously then have different parent SHA-1s, etc. This is why he treated it so bad. This didn't look like a mistake. This didn't look like something you could just, like, accidentally do. This looked like something where you had to intentionally go and break everything to make it look like this. The only thing, besides, like he was saying here, some broken scripting, is this had to be malicious. And from Kees Cook, well, I didn't do it on purpose. I think I have an established track record of asking you first before I intentionally do stupid things with Git. But like I said, I'll see if I can reproduce it. I have a lot of scripting to sanity check my pushes, and I stupidly overrode them because normally they get angry when I'm not basing on RC2, etc. But I've never had anything like this happen. Here's my ref log, but TLDR, it looks like before trailers did it. So what is before or before? This is a tool that most of you have probably never interacted with because it's kind of purpose made for doing the kind of development the kernel is doing. B4 is a tool created to make it easier for project developers and maintainers to use a distributed development workflow that relies on patches and distribution lists for code contributions and review. There's not really many doing that that aren't also using GitHub or GitLab or something else which manages all that fun stuff for you. And then the trailers functionality is basically used for handling code reviews. Now here we have Constantine's response. Yeah, this is danger territory because you're asking to update a random commit in the tree history without passing dash dash since, that is this flag right here, only used with dash capital F. By default, B4 will only look for your own commits as far as 1 month ago. With this flag, you can instruct it to look further back. So without passing dash dash since, we're looking at raw Git history in the current branch as far as 1 month back to try to figure out the range of commits we should work with. I don't yet know why it wants to rewrite 39 commits when we're updating a commit that's only 3 away from the tip. If you manage to rerun this with before dash D, send me the output. I'll be glad to look at it. Alternatively, if you can let me know the steps to get my tree in the same state as yours, I can run it locally. Well, that's the point where the user in theory goes, this is weird. Why is it 39 commits and does control C? But I'm happy to accept blame here. We should be careful with this operation and bail out whenever we recognize that something's gone wrong. To begin with, we'll output a listing of all the commits that will be rewritten just to make it more obvious when things are about to go wrong. Thanks for looking into this. Linus, this is accurate, and I'm 100% convinced that there was no malicious intent. My apologies for being part of the mess through the tooling. I will reinstate Keyes' account so he can resume his work. So even though this is something that Keyes did on his tree, and this is something that Keyes submitted to the kernel, this is still a problem that was in part caused by kernel tooling. And that shouldn't have been a state that was possible to get into in the first place. Even with that being the case, Keyes did still cause a bit of a ruckus here and probably should have checked things over before submitting them to the tree. My mistakes were not noticing the 39 commit warnings, overriding my push sanity checks, sorry about all the noise and confusion. The thing with the SSD was just a red herring, had nothing to do with what was actually going on. Honestly, the second that Linus says, hey, all of these commits consistently look wrong, that's obviously not going to be an SSD glitch unless you have the craziest bad luck. And now knowing what has actually happened, Linus redirects his annoyance over to the tooling away from Keyes. So the real danger territory is lying about committer information. That's the thing that no standard tool should ever do, and what made me so upset. Constantine, can you please fix before to never ever rewrite a commit that has different commit information than the current user? I don't think this is about 39 commits down. This is apparently before just doing plain bad things, and it would be bad even if it was only rewriting the topmost commit. Setting authorship to somebody else is normal and expected. Author is about giving credit, but setting commit information to somebody else is not about giving credit, it's about lying. Tools that do that are broken tools. I'm also not clear on why apparently the script tries to retain committed dates. That's also just plain lying. Following all of that, Keyes submitted a new patch set, and there was absolutely no issues here. Literally none. The only comment here is from the PR bot telling him the patch set was merged. Now, I have a lot of respect for how Keyes handled the situation, taking responsibility straight away and just dealing with the problem, sorting things out as quickly as possible. If you want to have any minor criticism here, I guess you could say Linus should have apologized for the way he spoke to Keyes. I totally understand, that is fair. At the same time, Keyes has been in the kernel for a very long time, knows how Linus is, understands why it was handled the way it was. So I'm happy all of this was just dealt with. I have been noticing a lot of people reporting on this as malicious commit attempt, dangerous committer, all of this stuff. Nothing dangerous happened here. All it was something that looked kind of shady, but it was actually kernel tooling breaking.